May Almighty's peace be upon you all. First of all, I seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and protection from evil in the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. It is both a great privilege and a special responsibility for me to appear before you to deliver a general message that will signify the objectives of this movement. Today, 23rd November 2024, marks a critical moment in our struggle for the rights and dignity of the Rohingya people. As part of the youth movement for Arakan, we stand in solidarity with the oppressed and in defiance of the injustice we continue to face. 6 years ago, Myanmar and Bangladesh signed an MOU, so-called Memorandum of Understanding, to repatriate the Rohingya. But has anything truly changed? The answer is clear: no. Thousands of Rohingya remain trapped in overcrowded camps, unable to return home. The MOU failed to address the root causes of their displacement: violence, ethnic cleansing, and the denial of basic rights. The atrocities are not in the past. They are still ongoing in Arakan. The promise of repatriation is empty as Myanmar continues to deny the Rohingya the right to live with dignity. But we, the youth, will not be silent. We reject a future of continued injustice. The voices of the Rohingya will not be silenced. We rise in unity for justice, dignity, and voluntary repatriation. We call on the Myanmar junta and Rakhine rebel groups to end the violence and discrimination. We urge the international community to hold Myanmar accountable and ensure the Rohingya can return home safely and with dignity. The Rohingya are not just refugees, they are human beings with the right to live freely, to belong, and to thrive in the land of their ancestors. Their sovereign must not be forgotten. Let this be a call to action. We stand united with hope for a brighter future and the belief that change is possible. The struggle for justice will continue until the Rohingya are free. Assalamualaikum.